Hello, everybody. What is going on? This is Will here, and this is the best I could do. I know it's a cat and not a dog, but I wanted to get Mumei next to it. This is the best I could do, I think. Nanashi Mumei's main weapon are her bird feathers. Her special attack is called True Horror, and she has three other unique skills: Friend, Civilization, and Bloodthirsty. Looking to her base stats, she has a right on the borderline of average HP stat of 60. She has a very low attack scale of 0.8 times. If I'm going just off of quick memory, I believe that this is the lowest attack scale that currently exists in the game. She has a perfectly fine speed scale of 1.4 times, the second highest current possible crit rate of 5%, and a bounce ball size of 2 out of 5. Her main weapon, Bird Feather, will shoot a bunch of feathers in a spread-like pattern. These feathers will pierce through targets. Interestingly, you only have one instance of damage increase, and that's when the Bird Feather hits level 2. Other level ups will involve shooting additional feathers, as long as increasing the hit limit of the feathers. The hit limit being how many enemies the feather can strike when it collides with the opponent before it terminates. So as you can see, from levels 1 to max, you can add 10 more to the hit limit on these feathers. Once you hit level max for the awakened bird feathers, the feathers will now start to home into targets 3 times. So as you can see, right from level 1, the hit limit is at a default of 5, so you can strike 5 enemies per feather before they terminate. At level 1, of course, you can just do some simple multiplication to realize that you can essentially hit up to 10 enemies, since 2 feathers can each hit 5 enemies at a time before terminating. So we can essentially generate 10 shots of 120% scaled damage per attack from the bird feather. This on its own is not terrible per se. The problem is just the very narrow scope of this weapon. And this narrow scope is completely corrected as soon as we get it up into the awakened form, because these feathers will now start to home in on targets. So once again, we have an instance of the wiki not knowing how to do math when you start with a base hit limit of 5 and you're able to add 10 more over levels. Obviously that hit limit is 15, not 10. At awakened level 7. But again, you can do some math out with that. You have a slightly higher scale damage at awakened form because of the 20% boost at level 2, meaning you have 144% damage scale. But having up to 4 feathers that can each strike 10 enemies means that you are able to generate up to 40 instances of that damage scale per attack. The fact that this also homes in on enemies 3 times basically guarantees that you're always going to exhaust that hit limit per feather, which makes for, while not the strongest weapon in the game per se in numbers, makes for probably one of the most efficient weapons in the game. Every time a bird feather is being shot out, there is a very good chance that you are getting the most use out of it you possibly can. In a game where everything is basically working off of auto shots, that is very important. It should also be noted, of course, bird feather is gifted with the privileged multi-shot category, which makes this weapon just even better. Mumei's special attack, True Horror, has a cooldown period of 80 seconds, which definitely puts it on the longer side. You will destroy everything in sight by flashing up the creepy face picture that Mumei drew in her famous stream, effectively making this entire special attack a screen wipe. Once again, similar to the feathers, very, very efficient usage of a special. You will also get a haste boost of 1% per target that you sacrificed or, you know, deleted, saved, KO'd with this special attack. And this buff will last 10 seconds. Looking to the notes on the wiki here, it should of course be noted there is a brief window of invulnerability that this special grants you upon using it, which is very helpful tech to know. That qualifies this special attack fully as a panic button. Only enemies visible on the screen at the time of activation will be affected, so if you activate it when the screen is kind of ported in one position but you're kind of still running in a certain direction, it's not going to like spread shot across that would-be wide swath of area that you've exposed to your screen. It will only be the section of screen that was visible at the time you pressed the special attack button. And of course, you can't hit bosses and mini-bosses with this special. This, of course, has infinite hit limit and has no base damage because it's simply screen wiping. It is deleting an enemy regardless of HP. Really, really solid special attack. Mumei's first skill, Friend, will summon Friend, the little paper bag ghost guy. And Friend will float around and use Bird Feather at a 50% power scale at level 1. At levels 2 and level max, Friend's behaviors will stay identical, except expand the repertoire of weapons that it can use from Mumei's weapons inventory. One random weapon at level 2, or two other random weapons at level max. And the power scale on all of these weapons will increase to respective 65% and 80% of their base power. This is a fantastic ability. This is, of course, just another sort of quality of the game in its current state that creates sort of have and have not characters. Characters that have familiars basically end up becoming, on a grade at least, usually better early on than most other characters. And Friend does two very good things. Friend will fire out weapons on your behalf, thus extending not only your DPS, but also the effective range of some weapons, but also acts as its own little pickup range area. So this is also an effective pickup range boost, and an enormous one as well. There's a fun little tech you can use with Friend, where Friend will actually react in different ways to the rotation of your aiming, so you'll kind of get a fun feel for it, and it's definitely more noticeable with twin stick controls rather than mouse and keyboard, but you can kind of control the rotation speed of Friend as it revolves around you. You'll be able to see it. It's not something really to take into huge account when you're playing Mumei, but it is a tech to keep in mind. Her second skill, Civilization, grants an attack boost of an iterative 1, 1.5, or 2% boost for every target currently on your port of screen. The ceilings of these boosts will also increase per level, iterating from 100%, 120%, to 150%. In addition, you'll also gain a further permanent 1% boost for every 100 targets defeated in the round. Of course, should be noted that these are additive bonuses, so these will just be expressed as bonus percentages on your attack boost when you go to your pause menu. And, you know, little history lesson, this was actually part of Mumei's rework, which appeared in this latest update 0.6. Mumei used to have another skill rather than the upcoming skill we haven't talked about yet, Bloodthirsty down below. Bloodthirsty used to be called History. Now, I won't get too much into the details of how any of those skills updated, mostly because they're mostly irrelevant now anyway, but just a fun little fact. Civilization's great, and this is one of the ways that Mumei addresses her low attack scale. It's one thing to be dealing out weak attacks, but now we're also getting some attack boosts through our kit, and we have two very efficient ways of screen clearing in spite of our low attack scale, that being our highly efficient main weapon choice, as well as True Horror, simply able to screen wipe when it's off cooldown. This definitely makes up for a lot of Mumei's downsides, and depending on how you want to interpret it, it effectively makes Mumei one of the greatest crowd control characters in the game. It's just kind of crowd control with the Calliope Mori school of thought, which is just the best defense is a good offense. Except in this case, it's Mumei's best method of crowd control is a good aimed offense that just clears entire groups of enemies. You know, that's how you control the crowd, by putting them down. Speaking of putting them down, we're gonna get into Bloodthirsty. When a target is defeated, you will gain a stack of Bloodthirst. At 20 stacks, Mumei will heal 10% of her max HP and gain an iterative 30, 45, or 60% attack boost for 10 seconds. So again, knowing the rest of Mumei's kit right now, this is an extremely easy effect to proc. This will pair so well with maps that just constantly are flooding you with more enemies than you think you can deal with. Mumei is one of those characters that actually benefits from having more enemies on screen at almost all times. She's a character that many people will consciously take, you know, marketing perks out of from the shop. And of course, is also a character that you can definitely play around with Halu, because Halu will allow for more enemies to spawn on screen and take more hits to defeat. If Kobo is our berserker at a more melee range, I think it's safe to call Mumei our, like, range aged berserker in a sense. A very straightforward character though. We have another character that's, you know, again, very focused on DPS, much like Reine was, but we're definitely approaching it from a different angle. We of course don't have that money motif, but instead we're replacing that with a motif based around enemy presence and allowing the character to be buffed and stronger and more capable of dealing with the enemy the more of them there are. Looking to item recommendations, I'm going to start with the headphones. I think this is a very straightforward, level-headed choice to take. You could even make the argument that headphones is just a pretty generic good choice on any character, you know, much like something like Nightly Milk. We have some very overly offensive options for kind of controlling crowds, but nothing that's tactical or defensive based. And since the presence of enemies is what keeps Mumei powerful, you don't necessarily always want to go for true horror every time you need to clear a crowd or clear a way to kite. That's where something like headphones would come into play. Secondly, we're gonna go for idle costume. I know I just said that sometimes you don't want to use true horror, but you probably still want to use it as much as you can because it's just that good. It is the perfect special attack to always have in your back pocket. And so there's absolutely no shame in bringing down that 80 second cooldown by 40%. That will knock it down 32 seconds, effectively giving you a 48 second cooldown on your special. And that's going to really come in handy, not only with making sure you have something in the back pocket to clear out enemies that are causing you some trouble, but even for the purposes of our idle stage timed mode run, we need to make sure that we can just clear the screen at any time and eliminate enemies. Thirdly, we're going to go with Gorilla's Paw. Naturally, in other game modes, you might rather go for something like membership, but when we're not doing something like membership in timed mode, we'll go for Gorilla's Paw. There's various builds of Mumei that people like to use, some taking advantage of a crit rate and some not. So there's not really an objectively correct way to build Mumei in that sense. It's just apples and oranges. For a weapon recommendation, I'm just gonna go with the BL book. Again, we have an aimed, very narrow spread while dependably home in on enemies and turn and snap back at foes in a crowd up to three times is still aimed, and then at the end of the day, unpredictable as to where those shots are actually going to go on the screen. Therefore, it's good that we take a dependable radial that can protect us at all sides that matches our shot type. And for a stamp recommendation, I think, again, there's quite a few stamps you can take with Mumei that are all pretty good, and it's just because the main weapon itself is already pretty great. The two that I like to take, quite honestly, are the projectile up stamp so that you can just give Mumei two more total projectiles. That means six feathers are being shot out, which is a pretty huge increase in the total number of hits you'll be able to generate per attack. The other one is just the pacifist stamp. I think that this is a pretty underrated choice on someone like Mumei. Again, just because she has good CC capabilities due to how overwhelmingly strong she can get for a moment, but you could still be a little vulnerable to the odd projectile being thrown out here and there. These projectiles can also make it harder to go for risky kites, which are already pretty risky if your only defensive option is something, you know, like headphones. So sometimes it can just be really helpful to nullify a projectile at times. Just, you know, you remove it from the game, it's not your problem anymore, it's not Mumei's problem anymore. Overall, I'm looking forward to playing with Mumei. It's an oldie but a goodie. Everyone in this game has probably already played Mumei at this point. I don't really need to sing her praises. She is so versatile, despite how aimed and narrowed her overall kit seems, but it just goes to show she exemplifies everything that makes things good in this game, which is ranged weapons, multi-shot weapons, high attack, and panic button specials. Hollow Promise, you know, Council, whatever you want to call them, that whole group of characters all got treated pretty well by the devs in terms of how balanced and still really good they all are. And Mumei is just no exception. Basically everyone from this branch in this game is pretty awesome. Let's not waste any time though. Let's get onto the stage and we will go around with Nanashi Mumei. All right, and we are on the stage with Mumei. Again, this isn't the fourth goddamn time I'm trying to record this or anything. Please, please stop. Stop screwing me like this, game. Why do I get constant triples for hollows on boxes, but then I can't get anything that I want for my build? The items I picked aren't even all that uncommon. Well, I mean, okay. I mean, we're off to a good start. There's the BL book already. Not a whole lot to explain early on here. Mumei is a pretty straightforward character. As you can see, we have feathers shooting out. We have friends sometimes shooting out feathers while grabbing XP for us, which is quite nice. And we have like a single tooltip in the corner, which is denoting our bloodthirsty buff, which is a countdown showing us how long we have our buff for. There's our headphones as well. All right, we're off to a much better start this time than the last few times I tried to do this, which is good. That's a good thing. I'm happy for that. Not a whole lot to say early on here, of course. We're not really utilizing any of our skills to their fullest potential because we don't have them leveled up yet. And we don't have any of our major damage raising, be it buffs or items in the form of our Gorilla's Paw yet. So our overall damage is not looking amazing. But this is probably an alright time to use something like our special right now. So we'll probably do that. Oh, there's my Gorilla's Paw. Oh, we're doing fantastic. That's so many things we already have collected. Let's use our special though. As you can see, we get the little visual accompaniment there of the cursed creepy picture, of course, a little jump scare. And it cleared the whole screen for us. And of course we were, a little bit invincible for that entire time, which was also quite nice. Again, makes a fantastic panic button. Lastly, of course, if we could get this idol costume, that would kind of complete our little approach here, which would just make our special a little more spammable if we need it to be, which is never a bad thing in this sort of a game mode. And there's our idol costume. Guys, we got everything but the pacifist stamp so far. That's fantastic. Wow, this is going way better. This is going like a million times better than the last time I tried to do this. Wow. I might go for another clear here. There we go. As you can see, we're already down approaching at least the 3,000 mark for enemies defeated, which is pretty great. Again, it makes Mumei... Mumei is definitely gifted with her special attack here in this specific game mode. It's definitely going to make her look a lot better than other characters by a mile. But, we'll kind of have to... We'll have to take that into account to a certain extent, at least. Mumei is still quite good. But yeah, her special kind of trivializes this game mode when you start comparing her to other characters. Let's get Friend to swing around here. Here's an example of some of our little tech there. You can, again, very subtly improve Friend's rotation a little bit by moving both twin stick directions in a certain way. Basically to sync up with where he currently is on screen relative to Mumei, you can use both sticks to kind of influence the speed he's going to rotate because of that. We got a triple, and it's all things we need leveled up, so that actually immensely helps us. That's like getting three level ups at once. When they're all things that we can actually take, that is great. Because now we can see the awakened feather and how much better it is. Like, look at this, man. We're like, the guy. We're like the blue guy from Guardians of the Galaxy. Remember he had the stick thing? And he'd whistle and it'd start flying around everywhere. That's what Mumei's attack reminds me of. If you know. Yeah, so we definitely have our kit going now. As you can see, 40 damage, 30 damage, it's not like, some 50s, it's not the highest damage in the world, but just it's the speed at which we are just expending all of this damage. Like, look at that. We made that boss disappear just in the middle of that little ramble. That's incredible. That's so good. Like, Mumei, again, I wouldn't say Mumei is, like, the single strongest in the game, but just, like, the amount of efficiency to be a killing machine just packed into this one kit is pretty nuts. Bloodthirsty starts kicking in and constantly healing you as well. So it's kind of the closest thing you get to a damage mitigation. I wouldn't call it a damage mitigation, but, it's getting somewhere around there, right, in terms of practical usage. Now, one thing you should notice is that you don't get a chance to get constant upkeep necessarily on your bloodthirsty trait, right? So the tooltip for gaining the buff and building up the stacks for the buff actually share the same tooltip. I cannot believe we actually got pacifist stamp. We got everything that I recommended. Mumei, you are the bomb, dude. But yeah, as you can see, they share a tooltip technically, right? So you don't actually get to constantly have the bloodthirsty perk up. It gets pretty close, right? When you're killing things as quickly as we are now, it's pretty close to constant, but it is not constant, right? It's not constant uptime. It's impossible to be constant uptime. So that's another consideration to take. And of course, they have to do it that way because the healing is like built into the effect as well, right? So they can't just have you kind of you know, willy-nilly going for it. And we're already nearing, I mean, we're getting down to below 1,000 here. We'll be getting there pretty soon with just this much damage getting thrown out here. Look at that. And we're not even at 8 minutes yet, guys. Again, just like efficient little killing package here. It is pretty fantastic. And as we just get bombarded with more enemies, as you can see, our damage ticks just keep going up, right? We were hitting the odd 100 right there, right? As we keep walking by, it's kind of, you know, dipping from 40 to 70 up to 100. Right? And it's just as we can keep populating our screen with more and more enemies, right? So going toward the danger, more often than not, is kind of the way to do it, right? As you can see, we're at 500, right? Like, you can see the way that this defeating just kind of starts to snowball out of control, right? In the best way possible, let me just say. As you can see, there is another probably 60 or 70 defeated right there from our special. There's our maxed out lava buckets now too. Look at that, look at all these lava buckets, right? The reason why there's so many on screen right now is because I believe Friend is also casting it at the moment. So we just are really, like, look at this. Like, let's just grab Hope Soda for kicks, right? Like, we can't even deal crits right now, but why not? Because there we go. 8.5 minutes, guys. Just to let you know. How crazy good Mumei is. She's a staple when it comes to getting productive things done in this game. And this is the reason why. She just starts going crazy the crazier the round gets, right? There's some characters where that's not necessarily the case, and it doesn't create necessarily an infinite scale for Mumei. Theoretically, it's infinite, but it doesn't translate into always keeping up, right? Otherwise, Mumei would just never die in any endless run ever, right? So that's not the case necessarily, but man, look how good that gets. 837. So good. All right, we've got some garlic to pick. As I spilled in the last episode, I basically just end up planting whatever I have the most bags of at any point, so this time it was just all garlic. That was Mumei though, guys. What a great character, right? We just had like some back-to-back, like, good old-fashioned reasons to play like the strong characters in this game, right? Just these ranged, just like fun projectile-based sort of DPS characters. It's so much fun, right? You know, it's why most people play this game, right? You just want to turn your brain off. You want to have the projectiles fly. It's almost zen in a sense, you know what I mean? It does almost approach like a cozy game in a weird way. A real treat, right? Truly the comfort food of this game, and I'm all here for it. Let me know what you guys think of Nanashi Mumei down in the comments below, be it the character in HoloCure or the VTuber in HoloLive. Be sure to let me know down below what other talents you would like to see for future showcases, guys. KU and his team were actually hard at work developing another fan game, except this one actually being properly under the Holo Indie label. So the game is called Holo X Break. I've not taken a look at all into it yet, but it would be interesting to give it a try. Maybe next week we'll take like a 1 week break from showcases here and I'll talk about another game kind of in this vein, right? It feels kind of weird talking this in depth about this game when we so closely associate the person who made it, but then not really play any of the creator's other games. So I think this is only appropriate to do, but let me know what you guys think ultimately down below. Be sure to like the video if you liked what you saw, guys, and subscribe if you'd like to keep seeing HoloCure showcases and other gaming content. Be sure to follow me on Rumble and Odysee if those are places you frequent, but most importantly, guys, I just hope this passing week treated you all very well, and that the upcoming week will only continue to treat you just as well as I hope the previous did. Take care, and we'll talk soon.